We are live in downtown Grand Rapids right now, and of course, Art Prize is not the only thing going on this weekend in Grand Rapids. The brand new Confluence Festival is happening tomorrow and Saturday at Calder Plaza. Joining me right now to talk a little bit more about this, Brian Cohen. Thanks for joining us.
Absolutely. Glad to be here.
Well, tell me a little bit about the story behind the Confluence Festival. How did we get this started? What happened?
Yeah, it's an interesting story. Confluence was born late last year in the middle of the shutdown, the middle of the pandemic. A lot of event talent was available. It was a tough time, but rather than be depressed, I thought, let's take advantage of it. Let's look at this as an opportunity. Let's bring these people back together and create something new for the region. So Confluence was born out of that idea.
Okay. And everybody is looking to find something positive out of the pandemic and the shutdown specifically. When you say, the talent that was available, talk about what we would find when we go to this festival.
Yeah, absolutely. So it's a festival based on innovation, and we're looking at innovation within four different pillars: art, music, science, and technology. And what happens when work in each of these areas come together? The buzzwords of the last decade or so has been disruption and collision.
Yes.
We're looking at the other side of that coin. What happens when innovation in art overlaps with innovation in science or technology or music? What kind of positive things can result out of that interaction? And that's really what we're celebrating and demonstrating all weekend long at Calder.
Okay, so tell me some of the things that I might find when I love the concept. It's very different.
Yep.
What would I find when I go there? What would I see as some of these exhibits?
Yeah, so it's a multidimensional festival, so there's a lot going on. Friday, you're going to see our music showcases. We have terrific national talent coming in from all over the country: Robert DeLong, Pat Locke, Old Man Saxon. So Friday, you're going to see the music, and you're also going to see what we're calling art at Confluence, which isn't fine art. We're really doing a digital takeover of the entire plaza with projection and color and sound, so that you're going to have, you'll be able to experience the music under this canopy of this digital takeover. That's Friday. Saturday, we have all day long, starting in the morning with our Future Innovator Zone, which is an area especially for kids. Hands-on, terrific activities and robotics and drones, all kinds of things to get kids really excited about what's happening in all of these pillars: our music, science, and tech. We have a Maker Expo, which is for our DIY community, people who are doing incredible things in their basement and their garages. We want a place for them to come out and be able to get in front of the public. We have an innovation showcase, which is looking at startups within the high-tech world, but from communities that are traditionally underrepresented in high-tech. So communities of color, women, others, we wanted to give them a spotlight as well, so they have their own section just devoted to them.
Well, there's so many things you can see and do.
Absolutely.
My word. What a great idea. Okay, and it's always changing all weekend long, so it depends on when you go and what you'll come across when you get there.
Yeah, absolutely. Half a day Friday and then all day long Saturday. And then an important thing is what we were able to accomplish this year is it's a completely free event. So there's no ticketing. There's no barrier to admission. We want the whole community to be there. We don't want anyone to be able to say, sounds great, but I just can't come for any reason. That was important.
So it's free. And it's this weekend. It's the Confluence Festival. Brian, thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate your time. It sounds like a great event.
Terrific. Thanks very much.
You're welcome.